Hello everyone, welcome to SemiConTalk. Today's topic is wafer-level chip-scale package. Let's talk about it. Wafer-level CSP is the smallest package in the market. Its die size equal with packet size. Usually, packages use substrate like lead frame or laminate, but wafer-level CSP does not use package substrate. So, wafer-level CSP consists of die, lead passivation, and bump. That's it. For lead passivation, PI and PBO are popular. In most cases, PI is used thanks to its thermal stability, good chemical resistance, and excellent mechanical properties. Cure temperature of standard PI material is around 350 degrees C, and lower cure temperature PI like at 250 degrees Celsius or 200 degrees Celsius are available. These low cure temperature PI are for memory devices which is sensitive to temperature. Major supplier of PI material is HD Microsystems, and this company is a joint venture between Japanese company Hitachi Chemical and US company DuPont. And Hitachi Chemical changed its name to Showa Denko, so now HD Microsystems is a joint venture between Showa Denko and DuPont. Size of wafer-level CSP can be less than 1 by 1 millimeter and up to 6 by 6 millimeter or even larger. But most cases, people use wafer-level CSP for less than 6 by 6 millimeters because larger one can have some issues for board level reliability. As I mentioned before, wafer-level CSP does not use package substrate, and that is a big difference from conventional packages. And for process, wafer-level CSP use batch process. It means all dies in one wafer are processed at the same time. Then it lowers process cost. For example, bumps for all dies in one wafer are made at the same time rather than one by one for conventional packages. The most popular structure of wafer-level CSP is bump on bond pad. In this structure, bump is located on top of die bond pad. So, bump location is same with die bond pad location. The other popular structure is bump on RDL. In this structure, bump is located at a different location from die bond pad, and bump is connected with die bond pad using RDL. RDL is made of copper. Typically, wafer-level CSP has die size from 1 by 1 millimeter to 6 by 6 millimeter. Bump pitches are 0.5 mm, 0.4 mm, 0.3 mm, or even smaller. But 0.4 mm pitch is the most popular. 0.5 mm was the most popular before 0.4 mm. RDL thickness is from 4 micrometers to 10 micrometers, and sometimes it has 20 micrometers or thicker. The thick RDL are for high current carrying application like wireless charging. We can compare wafer-level CSP to conventional wire bonding package and find out differences. Sometimes wafer-level CSP can have backside coating as an option, and it is to protect die backside from mechanical damage. Die is exposed in wafer-level CSP, so it can be damaged like a chipping or a crack, and backside coating protect die from these damages. For actual product, it looks like this. You can see a layer at die backside, and that is backside coating. It can be made by coating of liquid material or laminating film. Using backside lamination tape is popular, and Advil LC tape from company named Lintec is a popular product. This tape is also used for laser marking on die backside. For bare die, laser removes part of die material at die backside to make the marking. For die with backside lamination tape, it marks on tape rather than die backside, so it does not remove part of die. So, backside lamination tape is getting more popular, but it is additional material with additional process, means additional cost. Another option is side protection. It is to cover die with mold compound to protect die from mechanical damage as well. It can be all three sides, including four side, front, and backside of die. Five side except die backside. And four side except die backside and front side. Let's check process flow for bump on RDL, which is more complex structure than bump on pad. Step 1 to 4 are about PI. PI coating, PI exposure, PI developing, PI cure. This PI is used for lipespiration, and it is also photoimmiseable. So, photolithography can be used with this material. Step 5 is seed layer sputtering. This seed layer is used for following RDL plating. This seed layer is deposited on top of lipespiration, which is not electrically conductive. So, sputtering is used which does not need conductive material to deposit. Step 6 to 8 are about photoresist, PR coating, PR exposure, PR developing. It is to make pattern for following RDL by plating. Step 9 is RDL plating. Kappa is used for RDL, and previous seed layer is used for electroplating. Step 10 is PR strip. Step 11 is seed layer etching. Step 12 to 15 are about another PI. PI coating, PI exposure, PI developing, PI cure. Step 16 is seed layer sputtering. This seed layer is for following UBM. Step 17 to 19 are about another photoresist. PR coating, PR exposure, PR developing. Step 20 is UBM plating, bump plating. Step 21 is PR strip. Step 22 is seed layer etching and lip flow. Through lip flow, final hemisphere shape bump is made. Vapor level CSP is used for many applications, and power management IC and audio codec are more famous than others. For some devices, vapor level CSP should be covered by encapsulation with opaque material when it is mounted on board. It is to protect the vapor level CSP from external high energy radiation like UV, X-rays, gamma rays, and others, because some devices can be activated by these. Thanks for watching and have a nice day. Bye bye.